Get in the limo. Don't let this slide. You're going on an evolution ride into the country, a country drive. The show starts in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're going on a drive back to 1962. Now, judo chop. Going back to the 60s right now. You know, Elvis recorded this. John Fogerty recorded it. I personally think George Jones made the best job of it.
Best job. Best job Jones. That's what they used to call him. Just joking.
Uh-oh. I heard it was Hand Job Jones. Let me know when you're ready.
Yeah, I don't know why my E string is...
I got a second cousin to the COVID rammed up my butt, you know.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm not over it yet. I'm sure it's a second cousin to the COVID.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I eat the COVID for breakfast, you know.
Take your fake fingernail out there, Dad.
This is a new system where you start tuning when we get into the show.
No, something happened. I tuned before, but I think I tuned too early.
We're doing it in an A, this one?
Do you want to, or do you want to put it
sharp,
back?
Sharp, right?
Yeah. You're just always
I said to do it here?
No, well, it's one of the ones you go, I don't know if that's the right key.
No, I think that's going to be too high.
Yeah,
that's just too high to me. Okay. We're eventually going to get there. The second one will come quicker. Just because I asked a friend about her. Just because I spoke her name somewhere. Just because I rang her number by mistake today. She thinks I still care. Just because she haunts the same old places. Her memory of her lingers everywhere. Just because I ain't the happy guy I used to be. She thinks I still care. So if she's happy thinking I still need her, oh, let that silly notion bring her cheer. Oh, how could she ever be so foolish? Oh, where would she get such an idea? Just because I haunt the same old places, where the memory of her lingers everywhere. Just because I saw her then went all to pieces. She thinks I still care. She thinks I still care. She thinks I still care. Oh, silly girl. Get in the limo. Oh, well, yeah, we're going on a country ride.
Yeah.
Out to the cornfield of dreams where the old artists come out and request their songs.
Ooh, we're gonna take a ride.
Maul, I decided that I wanted to be more like James Bond.
Oh.
Yep.
That's a reason.
I got a James Bond thing going on with me. So I'm changing. I'm changing my last name. I'm changing both of them.
What are you?
I'm changing my last name to Foolery. Just like that name, you know, Foolery.
Yeah, Foolery.
And I'm changing my first name to Tom. Mm-hmm. So that when you meet me, just like James Bond, yeah, I'll be able to go, Tom. Tom Foolery.
No, Foolery. Tom Foolery.
Oh, is that the way it goes?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Okay, I'll get it next time, okay, you guys? Foolery. Right. Tom Foolery. Right, yeah. Good. It's good once you get going. It'll be all right. You had to blow it and say the right thing.
Yeah. Good. Yeah, you know, we're working out the kinks here. You want to take a ride?
Well, I'm thoroughly disappointed. You should have heard me laughing at that when I wrote it. When the writers wrote it, I should say.
You just can't turn off cameras, Dad.
You know, I was thinking about the bastardization of country music, you know, where they put all the pop and all that stuff in. I think it's a huge opportunity for the real country singers.
Yeah.
I think that everybody should quit bitching, because that anger, all that anger, there's a lot of anger, you know, in the classic country fans. A lot of anger. They can just channel that into the support of the real country fans.
Yeah.
Don't you think?
Totally. They're doing it.
Oh, we're gonna ride. Gonna take a ride.
Gonna take a ride.
I'm gonna take a ride.
We're gonna take a ride.
I'll pass a honky tonk.
Pass a honky tonk.
And pass the county line.
And pass the county line.
To the amber waves of grain.
Those waves of grain.
And pass the dairy cow.
With their big brown eyes.
To the old cornfield of dreams.
Cornfield, cornfield of dreams.
Only Molly can see the dudes. Who's coming out today?
Hank Williams and Buddy Holly, Dad. They want honky tonk blues and rave on. We can do it right here.
That fast?
Yeah.
Then just stay
there. Do whatever
there.
You want.
Well, I left my home and on a rural route. Told my pappy I was stepping out to get the honky tonk blue.
Hey,
honky tonk blue. Well, that's the load I got on. I got the honky tonk blues.
Yeah, Lord, I got 'em. I got the honky tonk blues.
Well, I'm 999, I wore all my shoes. Woke up this morning wishing I could lose. He's jumping honky tonk blues.
Hey, honky tonk blues.
Yeah, well, I said, Lord, I got 'em. I got a honky tonk blues.
Yeah, Lord, I got 'em. I got a honky tonk blues.
I done took my word, I need my arm. I'm gonna scare right back to my pappy's farm and lose his honky tonk blues.
Lose the honky tonk blues.
I lose the honky tonk blues.
Lose the honky tonk blues.
Well, I said, Lord, I got 'em. I got the honky tonk blues. I said, Lord, I got 'em. I got the Buddy Holly blues. Well, it's a little thing you say and do. Oh, it make me want to be with you. I said, rave on, crazy feeling. I know, got me reeling. I'm so glad you're revealing your love. Up for me, boom, 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 boom. Rave on, tell me, not to be lonely. Tell me that you love me only. Rave on for me. Yeah, the way you dance, the way you hold me tight, all the way you always say goodnight. I said, rave on, it's pretty, pretty. I know, got me reeling, I'm so glad. you're a bean and you're a love for me. Ba boom boom boom. Rev on, tell me not to be lonely. Tell me that you love me only. Rev on for me. I say, rev on. What about right after Buddy died? That other guy, come on. Who's that guy?
Which guy?
The guy with
started
that money.
Singing, bye-bye.
No.
Good.
You don't know the guy that came on after Buddy Holly. He took his place.
No.
I was breaking rocks in the hot sun. I fought the law. Law one. I fought the law. Law one. It's my baby and my six gun. I fought the law. Law one. I fought the law. Law one. I said I miss my baby and I feel so bad. Oh, guess my race is run. She's the best girl I ever had. I fought the law. Law one. I fought the law. Law one.
I fought the law, law one. I fought the law, law one.
Oh, I needed money cause I had none. I fought the law, law one. I fought the law, law one. I said I missed my baby and my six gun. I fought the law, law one. I fought the law, law one. I said it about the law, law one. I bought the law, law one. I said I miss my baby and I feel so bad. Oh, kid, my race is wrong. She's the best girl I ever had. I said I bought the law, law one. I bought the law, law one. I said it about the law. Loud one, I fought the law, and loud one.
Whoa. Yeah, sorry,
that's
that was
a loud little guitar. A very loud little guitar. Okay. I just thought I'd add that and make it a little bit more exciting.
Good.
You know, that
it
went from Buddy. Everybody maybe thinks Buddy wrote that song. He didn't.
Nope.
A new guy that came on wrote it.
Yeah.
And everybody thought it was going to be, whoa, this guy's like can write as good as Buddy.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's complicated. Relationships, small. Relationships. It's the most complicated thing in the world. That's what makes you have to have people that get along to get money. If you think about corporations and all, they got to get along, they got to cooperate, and they got to get along. And then in the end, once the money comes in, they got to share it.
Mm-hmm.
That's what you don't see in a lot of the world. They won't. They can get it. They got oligarchs and all that, but they won't share it too, right?
Mm-hmm.
You got to get along. I heard one fella say the most important thing about any country is, number one, that the people of that country produce more than they spend.
Mm-hmm.
And number two, they treat each other good.
Yeah.
See? Just one of the...
It's pretty simple, really.
One of the mysteries
but
of life.
But it's not as simple as you think it was.
Oh, that's just one of the mysteries of life. Heartache brought pain. And love's crazy game. I'd be a legend in my mind. If loneliness meant world to claim, everyone would know my name. I'd be a legend. Legend in my time. I'm not gonna go in it. It's going to mess up. Actually, it was the Hank Snow first, and then Ronnie covered it really well, but whatever.
Well,
who cares?
Let's get
back me into some of
the limo.
I'm changing my last name to Poovery. What?
Let's get back in the limo and get out to the show.
Okay, out to the show.
Get back in the limo and get on
door. Let's get out to the show, because out at the show is music, mirth, and the meaning of life. Going down right now at the show out there, getting the limo.
County line.
We gotta go. Because the girlies toes.
Yeah.
Because all the girlies toes.
All the girlies toes.
Are hanging out of the window. Somebody sees a great big tower. Big radio
station
tower.
GHRT.
50,000 watts, yeah.
Station
GHRT.
Station GHRT.
There for you and me.
It's there for you and me.
Brought to you by Alice's Restaurant
and
General Store.
You can get
anything you want.
Down at Alice's Restaurant. Down at Alice's Restaurant.
Pull up the station, go in the front door, and then go up to the front desk and see Betty Page. In her cigarette girl uniform, she's going to give you a special tea with the ayahuasca in it and send you downstairs here to the psychedelic prairie home companion. To the grand old osprey, they call it. You know, like the bird, the grand old osprey?
Seabird. Ooh, it's a bird that lives near the sea.
But it's the really big old-time radio medicine show, Three Chords and the Truth, starring Molly Griffin and her old dog, Boo.
And the Reverend Dr. Joe G2 coming to you live from Station GHRT in the virtual haystack in your mind, where the show always starts in 5 minutes. And we don't spin the tunes on the turntable, we spin them on our souls. So kick back, chill out, and relax to the mellow sounds of the singing DJs, DJs, DJs.
Haystack in your mind.
Haystack in your mind.
Gonna make you feel fine.
Feel real fine.
Rab you, boo, babo, badio, badio. Ain't got a dime. I'm sick, Mom. Not my usual.
You know,
my. Hey.
I feel like I'm gonna pass out this whole time.
No, I just wanted to say something. What was I saying? All right. Something about maybe it'll come up here. I'll see it again. It's a real cool thing to say. Oh, yeah, this is quite kind of funny. This is more poetry, more song or songwriting. I'm playing the black card and I'm playing it hard. Now, just a minute. I'm going to do it. I wrote one that's like Bob Dylan to show you how they do it, right? Because it's kind of a bullshit deal, right?
Okay.
You start slamming shit down that the human mind that hears it.
Yeah.
Could run with and go, oh, what does he mean by that? You know, that's heavy. That must be heavy. They assume that the guy's got his shit together. He's not necessarily got it together at all. Anyways, I'm playing the black card and I'm playing it hard. It's a rug on the ceiling from an old rebard. Bob Dylan.
Yeah.
So you got to figure that all out. You got to figure out what a bard is and what a rebard would be. And, you know, a rug on the ceiling. What does that mean?
Ooh,
supposed to be in the floor, isn't it? Okay, so that's how Dylan does it, right?
Yeah.
And then there's how Joe Griffin does it. He's, I'm playing the black card and I'm playing it hard. No rhyme nor reason. I'm just an old retard. Huh? That's better, isn't it? I think it's better.
I think the other one's more likely to make it through the
Oh, I know, but it's not honest. That one is honest. That one is honest.
I do kind of like yours more.
Yeah, it's better. You know, that's what Kathy Griffin said, or what was her name? Nancy Griffin?
Griffith. Yeah.
Nancy Griffith?
Yeah.
Is that what it is? What's wrong with you? Change it to an aunt. Well, you can't do it now. You're dead.
No,
too
she
late.
She probably can do it, yeah.
What, did she get the COVID?
I don't know. I don't think so. They would have been like, COVID. I think she was just sick of it.
You're going to laugh. You're going to cry. You're going to go, You're about to evolve, and we know that's all you really want to do.
And on that note,
We'll turn the page and sing what? You got a song?
Country Roads, Dad. Country Roads.
Oh, God. Okay. What key?
G sharp. We're already there.
Okay, well, I'd like to say something about Country Roads. It is a folk song. Folk.
Folk.
Song, right?
Mm-hmm.
But the Nashville sound, which Chet Atkins taught us, mm-hmm. when he reached in his pocket and shook the change, mm-hmm. and went, hear that in there? That's the Nashville sound. Because they just took it and made it a country song. And all got in on it, right?
Yeah.
Come on. John Denver was like a yodeling German guy up in the mountains, you know. Country road. You know?
Whatever.
I wonder how many of them classic country guys know that when they see, you know, I'm thinking about, you know, the big tall guy.
Blake Shelton.
No, okay, another one, an older one.
Johnny Cash.
No, and they usually go by just his initials.
I don't know, man.
I know, I'm stuck to it.
AJ.
What?
Alan Jackson.
That's right. He was right at the front of the line, wasn't he? Big country song, country roads, yeah. Because he's the one that's fighting for classic country, right? Well, this ain't classic country. Come on. Almost heaven, West Virginia. Blue Ridge Mountain, instead of Shenandoah River. Life is old there. Older than the tree, younger than the mountain. I said, blowing like a breeze. I said, country road, take me home to the place where I belong. I say to West Virginia, my mama. Take me home, a country road.
Take me home, country road.
All my memories, they gather round her. Miner's lady, or stranger to the water. And dusty, painted on the sky, misty shade of moonshine. I said, a teardrop in my eye. I said, country road, take me home to the place I belong. I said, West Virginia. My mama said, take me home, country road. Take me home, country road. Okay, and before we do that one again, I want to get with you on the guitar there. Because as soon as I see you, you know, that look. And where's he going? Yeah. That screws me up, right?
Okay. Yeah. I thought I was not looking at you that whole time.
Yeah, I could see you were watching my eye most of that D. And, well, yeah, okay. Anyway, get in the limo. We got to take a ride. Yeah, back to 1993. And don't forget to cooperate with your brain.
There you go.
Never mind that. Hey, I'm walking, talking. Hey, I'm a walking, talking soliloquy.
Ooh. That's a fancy word.
I looked it up. Yep. Popeye.
Yeah.
Sailor Man.
Yeah.
He mumbles on soliloquies. I just like the word soliloquy.
Yeah. It's a good one.
What about it, Joe? Now let's this is see, I'm just sitting there writing comedy, right? And I go like, hey, I'm a walking, talking soliloquy. Now let's rejoice in our perfections.
Mm-hmm.
I could have said, let's rejoice in our imperfections.
Uh-huh.
Would have probably gone over better. Oh, no, I know I'm supposed to do it. I'll try again, okay? Hey, I'm a walking, talking soliloquy. Now let's rejoice in our perfections. Bringing in the weed, bringing in the weed. We shall come rejoicing, bringing in the weed. Remember the song I wrote back when I was farming?
Yeah.
Every morning I get up, I go to work in the fields. I go to work in the fields of marijuana. Every morning I get up, I go to work in the fields. I go to work in the fields, but I don't wanna. No, I don't wanna. No, I don't wanna. Don't wanna work in the fields of marijuana. No, I don't wanna. No, I don't wanna. Don't wanna work in the fields of marijuana.
Yeah, I do remember. My childhood, man.
I should get a hold of all the big weed dealers now and make that the like the national anthem or something. I don't know. We're the growers.
Yeah.
All the farmers. National anthem. I don't want to work in the fields of marijuana.
Yeah. You should. You should do that.
Okay. Okay. Let's sing a song and then I'm just going to give one rant. Oh, golly. We got to hurry. Yeah. Or maybe I should give the rant right now.
Well, we can just do one more song too. We don't have to shove it all in there. Do the rant. What do you want to rant about?
Oh. Well, I'm starting to bother me about this Ukraine war, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Because I found out that Zelensky, who is now the global hero of all global heroes, is a pretty standard Ukrainian businessman.
Mm-hmm.
And the reasons he's doing so good is he's a TV producer.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see from the beginning of the war that he's been shooting this like a TV producer,
yeah.
Right? But the fact is he has offshore accounts. Looks just like a Ukrainian, you know, and he's hooked in with all the oligarchs.
Yeah.
Then and this is what I noticed because, you know, it ain't that long ago when Trump was going the whole thing about Biden's kid down there in the Ukraine, getting $150,000 a month. This is the Coke, the Coke junior lawyer, getting $150,000 a month from the Ukrainian oligarch. And, you know, doing weird business up in China at the same time, and Joe is, you know, you can hear they're talking about Joe and getting him some of it too, and all this stuff in there. And the next thing I know, this war happens, and now Joe Biden is trying to move $33 billion over to the Ukraine. Any chance there could be some like skimming? But you know how little you got to skim on $33
billion? Yeah.
To get a lot of shit and money? It stinks.
Yeah.
It stinks, Ma.
Yeah. It always does, Dad.
No, it doesn't. Well, yeah, a little bit. Stinks.
It always stinks.
And, you know, I'm talking about top of the class Joe, you know?
Yeah.
That's how he started his political career, at the top of the class. No, top half, I think he said, of the class, right? Yeah. He was second from the bottom. And he plagiarized the English guy's speeches and stuff. And he's just as phony as a $3
bill. Well, it's gotten him far. What we are learning is if you just cheat and steal and lie, you can be the president of the United States.
Yeah, sure as hell can. You can be vice president, too. What do you got now?
You can have either Gentle on My Mind or Where I Come From.
What do you think?
Maybe Where I Come From? That's what you're playing.
Got the notes out?
Nope. Got notes for neither. We could also do something else.
Now, how's it start then?
I was rolling gears.
I was working. I haven't. Never mind. Don't say nothing if you can't say it.
Okay.
Well, I was rolling wheels and I was sipping gears just around that Jersey Turnpike. Barney stopped me with his gun 10 minutes after midnight. He said, "Sir, you broke the limit here in that rusty old truck." "I don't know about that accent, son, just where did you come from?" "Where I come from? Cornbread and chicken, where I come from? Front porch picking, where I come from? Trying to make a living and we're working hard to get to heaven, where I come from?
Where I come from? Where I come from? Where I come
from. Well, I was south of Detroit City. I pulled in this country kitchen to try the brand of barbecue. I said the sign said finger licking. When I paid the tab, the lady asked me how'd I like my biscuit. I said, I gotta be honest with you, ma'am. That word like mama fixed it. Hey, where I come from, cornbread and chicken. Where I come from, front porch picking. Where I come from, trying to make a living. And we're working on to get to heaven. I come from.
Where I come from. Where I come from. Where I come from.
Well, I was chasing the sun on the 101 somewhere around Ventura. I lost my universal joint and I had to use my finger. This tall lady, she walked up to me and said, have you got plans for dinner? I said, no thanks, ma'am. Back home we like the girls that sing soprano. Hey, where I come from? Homebred and chicken, where I come from. Front porch picking, where I come from. Trying to make a living and we're working on to get to heaven. Where I come from.
Where I come from. Where I come from. Where I come from.
Well, I was heading home on the 61 somewhere around Kentucky. Bobtail rig with his TB on, yeah, he was rolling on like thunder. Well, I answered him and he asked me, "Sing it, and you from out in Tulsa?" I said, "No, but you might have seen me there. I just dropped a load of salsa."
Hey, where I come from? Cornbread and chicken. Where I come from? Front porch picking. Where I come from? Trying to make a living and we're working on to get to heaven. Where I come from. Where I come from. Where I come from. Where I come from.
All right, we did the best we could. I think we all evolved to a certain extent. You can't help it. If you creative growth and development going on, some sort of creative growth and development going on, which is what's going on all the time. All the time. Brain never stops. Nope, never does. So, because that's why we talk about that crap all the time. Because when you got your health, you got just about everything. We got the music. We got the family therapy. We got the music therapy. We got everything going on. So, and the reason we do is, and if you really need the big stuff, you go down to Griffin Heart Patreon. You get into the real big stuff. But anyways, and the reason for it all is when you got your health, you've got just about everything. And so you all come back now, yeah. And London, France, and underpants. Chad and China and Belarus. Good track down Ireland. Later, dudettes.